My name is Michelle.
My name is Oscar.
My name is Carlos.
Okay, one of the causes of human trafficking is force, which is the violent coercion or constraint applied on or against a person. So basically, when a person is peer pressured, and one of the causes, a few causes is that is high profit. So most times people are forced into human trafficking because they need to earn money for their families or if they're in low-profit community, are forced by their parents in order to gain money. And poverty, which is usually the same cause, their parents would often make their, the majority of times would be the daughters, they will make them go into human trafficking in order for money. And economic instability and political capitalism.
So some of the causes is desire for a better life, demand for cheap labor and tax and norms.
Disabled or pressure or someone to leave something behind or subjective a little rights, and some causes are desire or for better life, ignorance, demand for cheap labor.
And all those things I said leads to human trafficking. The definition of human trafficking is an illegal action taken towards a person or another causing harm while not having the consent of them and causing other damages to them, physical or mentally. It's a commodity. And then a commodity is a good or product that can be sold or bought. Like they sell a person, and with like a toy. Like, say this they act like that's a person, but no, this can be because a person has feelings and all that, but commodity is like selling something like as if it was an object. A victim is a person who is forced to deceive or coerced to do something and results in harm, injuring, or death. Examples: a hostage or a slave.
So there are five main types of human trafficking. The first one is sex trafficking. The definition of sex trafficking is the action or practice of illegal transporting people from one country to or an area to another for purpose of sexual exploitation. So basically, they'll get the person and they'll sell them from either, say, the United States to Canada. And then they'll pressure them into doing any kinds of sexual activities. And then we gave a few facts, but the majority that we want you to know is like the numbers. So the first number that we have is 150 billion, which is how much money traffickers will earn from sexual trafficking. And this is based on globally and yearly. And then for sex trafficking, there's 79% of women that happen, and then for men it's 29%. And again, for the data, within the database, there's 50,000 individuals that are in sex trafficking, and approximately there's 5,000 cases which are added each year. And at the current moment, there's only 7,000 and 900,000 victims that are being helped out and trying to, and well, you're getting assistance from getting out of the situation, while others aren't, either you're not known about, or they're in a tough situation that they're not able to get help, or they refuse help. Some characteristics is that you see in sex trafficking is that they can't really go from place to place, and they happen to be involved in the sex industry, and they're being bossed around by what you call a pimp, which is basically their boss that has like tricked them into being in sex industry, and they're either they're not paid or they're paid very little and they work very long hours.
The definition of forced labor is forcing a person to work in captivity or live on a pay. And the 4.5 million are victims of forced sexual potential, and the forced labor in the private economic rates in the U.S. is $150 billion in illegal profit for years. Guidance is one in four victims of modern slaves are children, and 5.4 victims and.
There's 5.4 victims that are currently in slavery out of every 1,000 people.
Women and girls are this. This performance is affected by forced labor, according to 199 of victims in the
commercial sector
and industry, and 58 in other sectors.
Yeah, I think it ran out of battery. You can just plug it back in. Is that about to end? Or is it still on?